Masa depan negara tidak hanya berpangku pada pendidikan yang baik, tetapi juga ditentukan oleh kesehatan yang baik. Pinang sebagai pencetak calon tenaga kesehatan yang harus memulai
masa depan negara
dalam membantu
tidak hanya
kesehatan yang semakin, tetapi juga ditentukan oleh kesehatan yang tinggi permintaannya. Pulau Bintan. Yang juga dikenal karena keramahannya, kemajemukannya, dan kebudayaannya, termasuk diantaranya sektor kesehatan. Kondisi geografis kepulauan menuntut ketersediaan tenaga kesehatan yang tidak saja banyak jumlahnya, tapi juga berkualitas sumber daya manusianya. Politeknik Kesehatan Kemenkes Tanjung Pinang sebagai kampus negeri pertama di Kepulauan Riau hadir dan mengambil peran dalam memastikan ketersediaan tenaga kesehatan. Didirikan pada tanggal 27 September 2011, kampus ini sudah mencetak ribuan alumni yang telah tersebar di seluruh penjuru negeri. Kami bertekad memberi ruang serta kesempatan yang untuk berpartisipasi dalam mewujudkan visi menjadikan perguruan tinggi bidang kesehatan yang bermutu, berdaya saing, dan berintegritas di tingkat nasional tahun 2024. Pentingnya prinsip sebagai panduan dalam berkehidupan, kami berkomitmen untuk melaksanakan Polkestan bertanjak, bertanggung jawab, santun, jujur, amanah, dan komitmen. Mewujudkan visi dan misi adalah proses yang panjang. Saat ini, kita bertekad mewujudkannya melalui 3 program studi. Program studi D3 Kebidanan, program studi D3 Keperawatan, program studi D3 Sanitasi. Kampus ini meraih banyak penghargaan nasional. Sudah terakreditasi institusi dengan nilai B. Poltekkes Tanjung Pinang meraih juara 2 dalam perlombaan TTG CKM 2021. Kita juga mendapatkan medali emas untuk teknologi tepat guna dalam kegiatan Global Competition Live for Science tingkat internasional tahun 2021. Sukses dimulai dengan keberanian, memulai untuk perubahan. Langkah kakimu hari ini akan menentukan masa depanmu di masa yang akan datang. Karena kamu adalah calon pemimpin di bidang kesehatan. Kami adalah tenaga pendidik yang siap untuk membantu kamu dalam mewujudkan mimpimu. Itu mengapa kelas kami bukan sekedar tempat belajar, melainkan laboratorium kami adalah inkubator ide, gagasan, dan inovasi yang senantiasa dikembangkan tanpa henti-henti. Zaman terus bergerak, tantangan menanti di depan, perlu disongsong dengan semangat inovasi agar memiliki daya saing dan bermutu tinggi. Kampus yang berdedikasi senantiasa melahirkan tenaga kesehatan terbaik guna mendukung visi Indonesia Sehat menjadi nyata. Dari kota Tanjung Pinang di Pulau Bintan, aku berjuang menapak masa depan untuk berani bermimpi besar. Aku percaya hidup yang baik itu dimulai dengan keberanian dan dituntun oleh pengetahuan. Setiap langkah kecil ikut berperan dalam mimpi besar mengubah dunia menjadi tempat yang lebih baik untuk ditinggali bersama. Menjadi rumah yang lebih hangat untuk dihuni semua. Jernih laut Bintan, ombaknya tenang, jadi tujuan banyak pejalan. Inilah Poltekkes Kemenkes Tanjung Pinang, tempat kelahiran tenaga kesehatan andalan.
Mari bergabung dengan Poltekkes Kemenkes Tanjung Pinang.
meyakini bahwa manusia dan kemanusiaan merupakan titik sentral setiap upaya pembangunan dengan menjunjung tinggi nilai-nilai kemanusiaan. Pelayanan keperawatan berupa bantuan yang diberikan karena adanya kelemahan fisik dan mental, keterbatasan pengetahuan, serta kurangnya kemauan menuju kepada kemampuan melaksanakan kegiatan sehari-hari secara mandiri. Bantuan keperawatan diberikan agar individu, keluarga, kelompok, dan komunitas dapat mandiri dalam memelihara kesehatannya sehingga berfungsi secara optimal. Poltekkes Tanjung Pinang dulunya merupakan bagian dari Poltekkes Riau. Setelah memenuhi persyaratan, Poltekkes yang berlokasi di Tanjung Pinang ini secara resmi berdiri pada tanggal 27 September 2011. Sebagai bagian dari Poltekkes Kemenkes Tanjung Pinang, Prodi D3 Keperawatan Poltekkes Kemenkes Tanjung Pinang memiliki visi menghasilkan lulusan ahli madya keperawatan yang bermutu, berdaya saing, dan berintegritas yang unggul dalam keperawatan gawat darurat wilayah kepulauan di tingkat nasional tahun 2024. Dan misi 1. Melaksanakan Tridharma Perguruan Tinggi untuk pengembangan pengetahuan dan teknologi keperawatan dengan keunggulan gawat darurat wilayah kepulauan yang bermutu, berdaya saing, dan berintegritas. 2. Mengembangkan tata kelola program studi D3 keperawatan yang kredibel, akuntabel, dan transparan yang dilandasi oleh etik dan moral. 3. Mengembangkan kerjasama Tridharma Perguruan Tinggi Bidang Keperawatan dengan keunggulan keperawatan gawat darurat di wilayah kepulauan dengan pemangku kepentingan, baik di dalam maupun di luar negeri. Prodi D3 Keperawatan memiliki struktur organisasi yang utuh dan memiliki SDM yang luar biasa. Hingga kini, telah ada 14 dosen terbaik di bidangnya, 4 laboran serta tenaga kependidikan yang ahli di bidangnya, yang mencakup peranata laboratorium pendidikan, administrasi, pustakawan, teknisi, hingga programmer. Adapun kepemimpinan lainnya berupa tenaga kependidikan D3 Keperawatan Poltekkes Kemenkes Tanjung Pinang konsisten memberikan pelatihan-pelatihan fungsional kepada tenaga pendidik dan terus berinovasi untuk mencetak generasi ahli madya keperawatan yang bermutu, berdaya saing, dan berintegritas. Terbukti, sejumlah produk penelitian yang inovatif dan berdaya guna berhasil diciptakan dengan memanfaatkan kearifan lokal daerah kepulauan. Tidak hanya itu, produk yang dihasilkan juga teknologi tepat guna, buklet, prestasi-prestasi yang didapatkan dari tenaga kependidikan, bidang BMN, serta arsiparis Poltekkes Kemenkes Tanjung Pinang dan Best Oral Presentation dalam International Conference, dan berbagai prestasi lainnya. Prodi D3 Keperawatan Poltekkes Kemenkes Tanjung Pinang berkomitmen menyediakan sarana dan prasarana terbaik untuk menunjang proses pembelajaran. Sebagai institusi yang besar, Poltekkes berdiri di atas lahan seluas 1,2 hektar. Mulai dari gedung perkantoran yang representatif, ruang kuliah yang nyaman dan modern untuk diisi 40 mahasiswa, gazebo untuk meningkatkan aktivitas mahasiswa selama di kampus, turut disediakan perpustakaan dengan koleksi referensi yang memadai, ruang konseling dan pendidikan kesehatan aula serbaguna, ruang kegiatan organisasi mahasiswa. Layanan kesehatan. Hingga beragam laboratorium sebagai tempat praktik mahasiswa. Seperti labor keperawatan gawat darurat. Labor keperawatan dasar dan keperawatan medikal bedah. Labor maternitas. Labor anak. Labor jiwa. Labor komunitas. Labor ilmu biomedik. Labor OSC. Labor bahasa. CBT. Untuk mewujudkan visi-misi Prodi, Prodi D3 Keperawatan melakukan kegiatan-kegiatan tridharma perguruan tinggi, mengembangkan kurikulum, melakukan kegiatan-kegiatan ilmiah, meningkatkan kompetensi mahasiswa, tenaga pendidik, dan kependidikan melalui pelatihan kegawat daruratan. Kegiatan pembelajaran di laboratorium melibatkan tim pengajar dosen maupun laboran yang berkompeten. Praktik klinik dilaksanakan di fasilitas kesehatan yang ada di Provinsi Kepulauan Riau. Seperti RS Marzuki Mah di Bogor, RSUD PMI Bogor, RSUP Raja Ahmad Tabib, Puskesmas sebagai UPT, RSAL Dr. Midiato, RSUD Kota Tanjung Pinang, Puskesmas Berakit di Kabupaten Bintan, SAR Kota Tanjung Pinang, Rumah Bahagia Bintan, berbekal inovasi-inovasi yang terus diproduksi, Prodi D3 Keperawatan Poltekkes Kemenkes Tanjung Pinang konsisten mendulang prestasi di kancah lokal hingga internasional dan beberapa prestasi lainnya yang membuat Prodi D3 Keperawatan memiliki daya saing yang tinggi. Sarana dan prasarana yang baik berdampak pada kualitas SDM dan civitas akademika. UKM unggulan dari prodi keperawatan itu adalah DMT, Disaster Nursing Team. Dan menyusul UKM Pramuka. UKM olahraga berupa silat, futsal, badminton, voli, dan lainnya. UKM kesenian, musik, dan tari. UHMI, English Club, pasukan pengibar bendera. Selain itu, mahasiswa prodi D3 keperawatan memperoleh beberapa prestasi yang di bidang kepramukaan. Bidang olahraga silat sudah menjuarai 3 besar di nasional. Tidak kalah penting dari prestasi tersebut, sangat banyak lulusan prodi D3 keperawatan Poltekkes Kemenkes Tanjung Pinang bekerja di berbagai rumah sakit, puskesmas, dinas kesehatan, dan klinik yang tersebar di wilayah Provinsi Kepulauan Riau, termasuk RS Bayangkara Polda Kepri, Rumah Sakit Ibu Ana, MTKI, BP2 TKI, dan di luar negeri seperti di Jepang.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Perkenalkan, nama saya Jusrian Sautama. Saya alumni Prodi Keperawatan Poltekkes Kemenkes Tanjung Pinang yang saat ini saya bekerja di Kantor Kesehatan Pelabuhan Kelas 2 Tanjung Pinang. Saya sangat bangga menjadi alumni Prodi Keperawatan Poltekkes Kemenkes Tanjung Pinang karena ilmu yang saya dapatkan sangat bermanfaat sehingga saya menjadi berkompeten di bidang pekerjaan yang saat ini saya jalani. Saya berharap ke depan Prodi Keperawatan Poltekkes Kemenkes Tanjung Pinang semakin berkembang dan maju baik dari segi akademis maupun non-akademis. Demikian, Prodi Keperawatan bisa.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Perkenalkan, nama saya Dir Medina. Saat ini saya bekerja di Polda Kepri sebagai Brigadir Bidokes Polda Kepri. Prodi Keperawatan, menurut saya banyak sekali mengajarkan hal yang bermanfaat dari pengalaman, ilmu, teman, dan lain sebagainya. Sehingga saya mau berdiri di sini dan mengabdi di sini. Yang saya harapkan, Poltekkes Prodi Keperawatan semakin maju, jaya, dan sukses selalu. Terima kasih.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Perkenalkan, nama saya Asri Fitriani. Saya alumni Poltekkes Kemenkes Tanjung Pinang jurusan Keperawatan tahun 2016. Sekarang saya bekerja sebagai perawat lansia di Panti Lansia Imaya yang berada di Tokyo, Jepang. Terima kasih.
Bergabung dengan Prodi D3 Keperawatan Poltekkes Kemenkes Tanjung Pinang. Kualitas pelayanan kesehatan, khususnya di Kepulauan Riau, untuk kehidupan ke depan yang lebih baik.
Keperawatan, merawat, mengedukasi, melayani sepenuh hati.
Sepanjang siklus kehidupannya, seorang perempuan berhak mendapatkan pelayanan kesehatan terbaik sejak masa awal kehamilan hingga masa persalinan dan nifas. Tidak boleh lagi ada 3 terlambat. Terlambat deteksi dini tanda bahaya, terlambat mencapai fasilitas rujukan terdekat, dan terlambat mendapatkan pertolongan. Jika hal ini tidak diperhatikan, angka kematian ibu dan bayi akan selalu tinggi. Angka kematian ibu dan bayi di Provinsi Kepulauan Riau harus ditekan. Kondisi geografis kepulauan jangan lagi dianggap sebagai hambatan dalam menyediakan pelayanan kesehatan, tetapi tantangan yang solusinya perlu ditemukan. Guna mengambil peran dalam mengurangi angka kematian ibu dan bayi, Prodi D3 Kebidanan Poltekkes Kemenkes Tanjung Pinang hadir dengan visi menghasilkan ahli madya kebidanan yang bermutu, berdaya saing, berintegritas dengan keunggulan kebidanan komunitas di daerah kepulauan tahun 2024. Program studi D3 kebidanan ini sebelumnya adalah akademi saat itu Prodi D3 Kebidanan Poltekkes Kemenkes Tanjung Pinang rutin melahirkan lulusan-lulusan yang bermutu, berdaya saing, berintegritas dan dapat diandalkan. Mereka terlatih dan kompeten dalam memberdayakan komunitas sebagai upaya promotif dan preventif dalam mencegah terjadinya kegawat daruratan maternal neonatal di daerah kepulauan. Tidak hanya itu, mereka juga mampu mengimplementasikan sistem rujukan di daerah kepulauan. Sebagai prodi D3 kebidanan yang terpercaya, pelaksanaan Tridharma perguruan tinggi tidak sebatas dalam kampus, tetapi juga di luar kampus. Pembelajaran di laboratorium melibatkan dosen dan pranata laboratorium pendidikan yang berkompeten di bidangnya. Praktik klinik dilaksanakan di fasilitas kesehatan yang ada di Provinsi Kepulauan Riau, seperti rumah sakit, puskesmas, klinik, praktik mandiri bidan, dan lain-lain. Yang juga tidak kalah penting adalah pembelajaran di komunitas dengan melakukan pemberdayaan masyarakat di daerah kepulauan serta melakukan rujukan kegawat daruratan maternal neonatal. Salah satunya melakukan rujukan dengan menggunakan transportasi pompong. Pompong merupakan salah satu moda transportasi yang dimiliki oleh Provinsi Kepulauan Riau. Komitmen Prodi D3 Kebidanan Poltekkes Kemenkes Tanjung Pinang untuk mencetak generasi ahli madya kebidanan yang bermutu, berdaya saing, dan berintegritas dimulai dari penyediaan tenaga pendidik dan kependidikan yang berkualitas. Hingga kini telah ada 15 dosen terbaik di bidangnya, serta lebih dari 20 tenaga kependidikan yang ahli di bidangnya, yang mencakup pranata laboratorium pendidikan, administrasi, pustakawan, teknisi, hingga programmer. Di atas lahan seluas 1,2 hektar, Prodi D3 Kebidanan Poltekkes Kemenkes Tanjung Pinang berkomitmen menyediakan sarana dan prasarana terbaik untuk menunjang proses pembelajaran. Mulai dari gedung perkantoran yang representatif, ruang kuliah yang nyaman dan modern, hingga beragam laboratorium sebagai tempat praktik mahasiswa, seperti keterampilan dasar praktik kebidanan, antenatal care, intranatal care, postnatal care, bayi baru lahir, bayi, balita, anak prasekolah, pelayanan KB dan kesehatan reproduksi, kegawat daruratan, maternal neonatal, dan basic life support. OSCE, biomedik, farmakologi, bahasa, CBT, serta laboratorium kebidanan kependidikan kesehatan. Aula serbaguna, ruang kegiatan organisasi mahasiswa, layanan kesehatan, musola dan asrama, bahkan kegiatan di luar akademik juga mendapat perhatian lewat penyediaan sarana kesenian. Sarana olahraga meliputi futsal, voli, tenis meja, dan lain-lain yang berstandar. Sarana dan prasarana yang baik berdampak pada kualitas sivitas akademika. Sejumlah produk penelitian yang inovatif dan berdaya guna berhasil diciptakan dengan memanfaatkan kearifan lokal daerah kepulauan. Produk yang dihasilkan juga merambah ranah teknologi, berbagai aplikasi, imodo, dan teknologi lainnya telah diciptakan untuk meningkatkan kesehatan ibu dan anak. Berbekal inovasi-inovasi yang terus diproduksi, Prodi D3 Kebidanan Poltekkes Kemenkes Tanjung Pinang konsisten mendulang prestasi di kancah lokal hingga internasional. Seperti dosen dan mahasiswa berprestasi tingkat nasional, best paper, dan best oral presentation dalam international conference. Dan beberapa prestasi lainnya yang membuat Prodi D3 Kebidanan memiliki daya saing yang tinggi. Prodi D3 Kebidanan melakukan berbagai upaya untuk mencapai visi-misi. Adapun kegiatan yang dilaksanakan berupa melaksanakan kegiatan belajar-mengajar sesuai standar nasional perguruan tinggi, melaksanakan kegiatan penelitian dan pengabdian masyarakat yang bermutu dan berdaya saing, serta senantiasa mengembangkan kerjasama di bidang tridharma perguruan tinggi. Prodi D3 Kebidanan unggul di bidang kebidanan komunitas kepulauan dan telah melakukan berbagai upaya untuk mewujudkannya, seperti menyusun dan mengembangkan kurikulum kebidanan komunitas kepulauan, melakukan kegiatan ilmiah tentang kebidanan komunitas kepulauan, meningkatkan kompetensi mahasiswa melalui pelatihan kegawat daruratan kebidanan komunitas di kepulauan. Bergabung dengan Prodi D3 Kebidanan Poltekkes Kemenkes Tanjung Pinang adalah langkah nyata untuk berpartisipasi dalam peningkatan mutu kualitas pelayanan kesehatan ibu dan bayi, khususnya di daerah kepulauan, untuk kehidupan ke depan yang lebih baik.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Saya Weni Angelina MSI. Selamat datang di Prodi D3 Sanitasi Poltekkes Kemenkes Tanjung Pinang.
Ada suara apa?
Sound checking. Cek.
Ada.
Sound checking. Ini jadi gini nih. Jadi ini gini. Good day, everyone. All participants still got healthy and happiness. Now on, it's turn to our head of department, consists of nursing department, midwifery department, and sanitation department. Shortly, we shall introduce our speakers. First from nursing department, Mistress Romalina, Master of Nursing. Secondly, Mistress Ramadona, Master of Midwifery. And the third speaker is Mistress Weni Angelina, Master of Science. Then, Now, first we have to be asked for your apologize. There is a little bit trouble with, what can I say, internet. So, we start from Mistress Ramadona or Mistress Winnie Angelina or Mistress Romalina. Enjoy your time with pleasant day.
Hello, Mr. Tarpen. Which one of us be the first presenter, me or Mrs. Romalina, as you said earlier?
It depends on all speakers. Which one of you will be the first speakers?
Well, if you don't mind, I will be the first speaker for this afternoon session, may I?
Of course, sure.
Let me share screen my presentation, please. Mrs. Sarpen and all the participants, this my presentation and my voice can be clearly heard or seen in your screen. Hello.
Of course, I hear your voice, but it's too.
Then allow me.
It's not loud and clear, perhaps.
But I heard clearly your voice, Mr. Hafen. Okay, then we started our presentation. Thank you for you, Mr. Hafen, for the opportunity given to me to present my presentation. Okay, before I start my presentation, let me greet all of you with a pantun. Berlibur ke kota Tanjung Pinang, singgahlah dulu di dermaga. Ketika ada yang mengucapkan salam, jawablah dengan lantang dan bertenaga. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi
wabarakatuh. Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Good afternoon, everyone. The Honorable Director of Health Polytechnic Health Ministry of Tanjung Pinang, all the speakers in this international seminar, the Honorable Chairman and Coordinator of Center of Excellence Health Polytechnic Health Ministry of Tanjung Pinang, and the Honorable all participants who have attended this seminar. As introduced by the moderator earlier, let me reply. My name is Rahmadona. I'm a midwife and also a lecturer at the midwifery department, diploma free midwifery study program. Give me a moment, please. For all of you who doesn't know, but don't know me yet, it's my city. I live in Tanjung Pinang City. My contact and this is my email. I'm a lecturer in midwifery department of health polyclinic Ministry of Health Tanjung Pinang. I'm also a midwife and also a happy mother of three children. My education background start from military school and in 1993. And my last educational is 2023. I'm a midwife from the midwife professional education program of Health Polytechnic Ministry of Health Jambi. I work mostly of my life work experience as a teacher. Start from when I finished my diploma degree, midwifery. I work as an educator at Tabrani Rak Midwifery Academy of Pekanbaru, and also an educator at Payung Negeri Midwifery Academy of Pekanbaru since 2006. And from 2006 until now, I'm an educator, midwife, and lecturer at Midwifery Study Program of Health, Polytechnic Ministry of Health, Tanjung Pinang. As a lecturer, I teach some many subject of courses. Example is midwifery care for mothers and neighbors, midwifery care for emergency of maternal, neonatal, and basic life support. I also teach anatomy and physiology, innovation in midwifery services, and interprofessional education or collaboration. Okay, that's all of my knowledge. Now we proceed to my presentation. On this occasion, I will present my research topic, namely husband companion in childhood. Let's start. Ladies and gentlemen, as we know, childbirth is a powerful transformative experience. For all involved, it's a time when women harness their incredible strength and resilience to bring new life into the world. And it's time when the presence and support of loving partner can make all the difference. In our society, the role for husband in childbirth has evolved significantly over the years. Gone are the days when fathers-to-be were relegated to waiting room, facing nervously while their partner went through labor and delivery. But today, we recognize the critical importance of the husband's presence during this miraculous process. Husbands, as companions in childbirth, have the opportunity to offer not only physical support, but also emotional and psychological support. They can provide a reassuring hand to hold, a comforting word to ease anxiety, and a loving presence that bolsters the birthing experience. This active participation in childbirth not only enhances the birthing mother's sense of security, but also deepens the emotional bond between partners. In according to this topic, we would like to share our experience researching husband companion in childbirth since 2020 until now. This is our research team. We are consist of me, myself, Rahmaduna, together with Mrs. Utami Dewi and Mrs. Nurniati. Some of the products, let me introduce you of the product our research. It is called Sumping. We can call it Support Suami Pendamping, Sumping. Sumping is an educational media that is used as guidelines for husbands to assist women on labor and to increase an active participation in childbirth process. So far, we have three products from our research. First, it is the e-modo Sumping, that is Sumping in the form of electronic form. Then we develop a printed edition of module Sumping. printed edition, and also we have video something. The information we convey in Sumping educational media includes an introduction to the birth process, birth companions, the role of husband in assisting childbirth, as well as guidelines for husband in providing assistance during childbirth. So what is underlies us for creating the Sumping educational media is that we realized that from data we collected, it is proven that more than 90% of maternal deaths are caused by complications that often occur during or around childbirth. So to reduce those complications requires participation of a husband. The presence of husband as a birth companion is very important because it can create a sense of security, comfort, increase the mother's self-confidence, reduce anxiety about the birth process, reduce the intensity of labor pain, reduce labor complication, and speed up the labor process. So to be able to provide good assistance during the birthing process, husband needs to have knowledge and skills regarding what to do during assistance. From our pre-searching or pre-studies, husband participation in birth assistance is still low, yet there is no special guidelines for how and what to do during labor assistance. Dari studi pendahuluan kami, rata-rata suami hanya hadir secara fisik di persalinan, tapi tidak tahu dan tidak juga punya panduan khusus untuk harus melakukan apa dan bagaimana melakukan pendampingan dalam persalinan. So, this is our research background. Based on those background, we started researching about this husband companion since 2020 until 2024 from our roadmaps of research. In 2020, we identified factors that relate to husband companion in childhood. From this study, we learned that husband needs special guidance on how to provide good labor assistance instead of just physically coming and accompanying the mother in labor. Based on those findings, we developed an educational media in the form of an e-module called Sumping, Husband Companion and Support, in 2021 and studied its effect on the length of labor process. In 2020, we are trying to develop a new form of Sumping educational media in the form of video and see the effect when connected to the husband's motivation in assisting childbirth. In 2023, which is this year, we are developing the Sumping educational media in the form of printed modules and trying to compare it with the Sumping video from the video form to find out which form provides the biggest change in husband knowledge and attitudes in assisting childbirth. Later, next year, in 2024, we plan to research about the use of Sumping in the form of e-module and video on husband independence in assisting childbirth. Our aim from developing Sumping educational media and conduct research using this media are to increase knowledge, develop positive attitude and motivation, and take an active role for husband in assisting childbirth process. We also aim to meet the needs of women during childbirth, such as needs of birth companion, need of feeling safe and comfortable, need of being free from anxiety, which is closely related to birth complication. The long-term goal we want to achieve is increasing the husband role in childbirth, which will have an impact on reducing birth complication and ultimately reducing maternal morbidity and mortality. Some method we used in our research include study object, of course. We use husband of more than 32 weeks of pregnancy. Husband or woman in first stage of labor. This is our study object. Type and design of our study, we sometimes use pre-experimental study or analytic observational study with the design of was only with control group design, two group pre-post test design, or two group post-test only design. We take a location of the study in all midwifery clinics in Tanjung Pinang City, also in Batam, Bintan, or Sariman Regency. Variables that we observe are the length of delivery process, also knowledge, attitude, motivation, accompanying behavior of husband during childbirth. We use a questionnaire sheet or observational sheet or pathograph as an instrument of study. Data that we are collect are analysis with univariate, bivariate, and multivariate analysis, and use a statistic test of dependent sample t-test, independent sample t-test, or another test that we need for the data. So from the 4 years of research starting from 2020 until now, we have come to the conclusion that from the result that we have to from 2020 and until now, as you can see on the screen, this is what we have in result on our researches. Except for 2023, we're still working on data, so no result yet. So from 4 years of research starting from 2020 until now, we have come to the conclusion that the Sumping educational media in the form of e-module, printed module, and video have an impact on increasing husband's knowledge, attitudes, and motivation regarding birth assistance. Research also proves that there is an influence of this educational media on the length of labor. For husbands who are equipped with Sumping educational media can provide full assistance in childbirth, thereby speeding up the delivery time. We hope that after our last research in next year, 2024, the Sumping educational media that we have developed will become an information medium that every husband can use as a guide in providing better delivery assistance, and every midwife service clinic can improve delivery services using this media. We also have published our research result in several national and international journals and have copyright on our research product. And we also use the result of this research as well as the Sumping educational media in the courses of we teach to students, promoting it to husband of pregnant women in community service activities, also used as an educational medium for husband and mother during childbirth. So this is some of our documentation on research and utilization of research. Okay, as I conclude the presentation of our research, I'd like to emphasize that the significance of our findings. This research has illuminated the transformative impact that husband can have during the childbirth process. It's not merely about their presence in the labor and delivery room, but about the active support they provide and the emotional bond that is strengthened this crucial moment of life. The implication of our research extends beyond the delivery room. We hope that this knowledge that we share by using Sumping educational media will not only encourage more husbands to take an active role, but also inspire healthcare providers to recognize and to facilitate their involvement. We believe that promoting husband companionship during childbirth is not just a matter of choice, but a matter of best practice in maternal and family health care. Thank you for your time and attention, and I look forward to the ongoing discussion and developments in this important field of study. Thank you very much. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Now I return time to Mr. Harfen as a moderator, please.
Thank you very much, Mr. Ramadona.
Mr.
Mistress.
Is this? Mistress.
Ada S di belakangnya gitu ya, Mistress.
Is this?
Okay, okay. I thought this paper is interesting, especially the main idea is Sumping. And I am wondering, perhaps there is a terms, one husband, one client in the past few years, and a couple decades ago, there is a Indonesian program that husband become a companion to his wife. But Mr. Ramadona will ask in the end of a presentation. Now on, it's turn to Mr. Winnie Angelina, Master of Science, will you?
Okay, Mr. Hafen Sika. Please.
Enjoy your time.
How about my voice, Mr. Hafen
Sika? Loud and clear.
Okay. Mrs. Ratna, please, can you help me to show my presentation? Because in my...
Okay, wait a second.
Yes.
Of course.
Maybe I can start. Maybe I can start, Mr. Francisca. Okay, thank you, Mr. Francisca, for the time. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. I am Weni Angelina from Department of Sanitation, Poltekkes Kemenkes Tanjung Pinang. First of all, Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alamin, thanks to Allah Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala, who has been giving us blessings and mercies so we can attend this conference in good condition. I also want to give my thanks to the Honorable Director Poltekkes, Director of Poltekkes Kemenkes Tanjung Pinang, Mr. Iwan Iskandar, MKM, and thanks to Honorable Center of Excellence Poltekkes Kemenkes Tanjung Pinang, congratulations for the first international conference. Thank you so much. And of course, honorable speakers and participants of this conference. Tadi berpantun, jadi mungkin saya juga akan berpantun. Sungguh indah bunga melati, berwarna putih tidak berduri. Semoga semua yang hadir di sini senantiasa bahagia sepanjang hari. Okay, thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, maybe how about the presentation?
Wait a second, please, Mistress. There is a little bit.
Okay. Okay, thank you. Miss Ratna. Ladies and gentlemen, in the Department of Sanitation, we have more specification. Consists of water sanitation and wastewater treatment, soil sanitation and solid waste treatment, air sanitation, vector control, sanitation of public place, and food and drink sanitation. On this occasion, I want to inform you about sanitation of public place, especially restaurant, and food and drink sanitation. Please next. This is the title of our research. The one of our research. Maybe this is.
I'm so sorry, Mistress Wenny.
Yeah.
There is a trouble with an audio from you, perhaps.
Okay. I'm sorry. Okay. The title of one of our research is an Android application to measure the risk level of disease transmission in restaurants. Maybe this is the past research. We have completed this research in 2021 when pandemic COVID-19. But I have notion to develop this application not only for COVID-19, but for preventing disease transmission generally disease in restaurant, especially the disease that caused by virus and bacteria. Okay, next, please next. This is our research team. There are Wayne Angel and MSE and Julia the MSE. I'm delivering about introduction, literature review, methods, result and discussion and conclusion. Please next. We go to the introduction. We know that a restaurant is a place of commercial business whose provide food and beverage to the public. So we can say that a restaurant is a public place where many people can meet for eating and drinking and relaxing activities. We know in restaurants, many people chatting, logging, and relaxing activities. Even in pandemic COVID-19, we know the one and only place when the people impossible to wear wore mask is in restaurant, because we can eat, we can drink, we can drink when we wear mask maybe. So they can be risks. The restaurants can be risks for a disease transmission. Unhygienic food processing and poor sanitary conditions will affect the bacteriological quality of food and will cause health problems. And the indicators of hygiene and sanitation should not only be known by health workers, or we can say sanitarians, but also the civil publics, the general publics, the civil persons, public person, so that the public persons can participate in assessing and monitoring them. Restoran akan lebih terganggu ketika ada visitors yang mengatakan, oh, saya tidak mau makan di sini karena tidak memenuhi persyaratan. More than seorang sanitarian yang mengatakan seperti itu. So, I think we must involve the public persons or the civil person to assessing and monitoring sanitation in a public place. So, for that, we need a simple and easy instrument. So, the these instruments can use by all levels of society, like and now Android applications. This next. Please next, Ms. Isra. So in the past, our objective research was to determine where to determine the level of sophistication of ROA for restaurant observation application users, and to determine the level of risk of disease transmission COVID-19 at restaurants in Tanjung Pinang City. This is our this was our application in the past. Okay, next. We call it restaurants observation application, ROA, ROR. Okay. Our methods, there were three steps. The first step, we created ROA application. So before created application, we must we ought to prepare observation sheets. This observation sheets based on decree of Minister of Health of the Republic of Indonesia number Indonesia, or we say keputusan Menteri Kesehatan. Nomor HK.01.07/Menkes/382/2020 about health protocols for the community in public place and facilities in the context of preventing and controlling coronavirus disease in 2019 or COVID-19. And after made an a questionnaire or an observation sheets, we create the and we inside it to inside them inside it to an application, an Android application. In the second step, after we have application, we must test a level of the satisfaction of ROI users. Our respondents are visitors of restaurants. They were selected accidentally. They are 18 to 50 years old, using Android friendly and willing to be respondents. Measurements are using a Likert scale. The level of risk of disease transmission. This is the third step. After we met the application, we used it to test a level of risk of disease transmission to 30 restaurants in Tanjung Pinang City, Riau Islands. Please next. This was our results. And this our this was our application. This is the logo. Maybe I can show you. This is in this was this is in di paling bawah restaurant observation application. It have three menus: info, lembar observasi, and hasil. This application we just install in our mobile phone, and we don't need to sign up or sign in. We can use it spontaneously. Okay, please next. Okay, the second menu is info. This menu displays information about infectious disease and their prevention. In the past, we fill it with information about COVID-19, consists of protocol kesehatan, protocol, bagi visitors, pengunjung, kemudian juga bagi pengelola dan bagi masyarakat umum for public. But for the next, maybe we can fill the info with information about other disease or about hygiene and sanitation of restaurant, maybe. Okay, next. The third menu is the second menu is lembar observasi. In this menu, consists of questions. So the civil person, the public person, can filling the questionnaire based on pendapat mereka, begitu ya, begitu melihat di rumah makan seperti apa, dan bisa mengisi. Nah, and then the results appear in the categories, in three categories: no risk, a risk, or very risk. Okay, please next. Okay, the third menu is hasil. This menu displays results for each restaurant. Results, if we are the civil person, if we are the public person, we just need three categories. Just does it risk or well risk or no risk. But if we academic persons, we can be downloaded these results in spreadsheets form, so we can analyze data for others. Okay. This next. Now, this is the results about the level of satisfaction of ROA users. From the pictures, you can see that the all respondents were very satisfied with the appearance of the application. We had 30 respondents, and all of them were very satisfied with the appearance of the application. They said this application is simple, is easy to use, maybe like that. And then, but about fitur aplikasi, responden were satisfied, just satisfied. More of them just satisfied with the application, because they said, how about you add physical measurements like body temperature, room temperature, and okay, kita tampung saja pada waktu itu. Kemudian. And then in most respondents, sebagian besar, were very satisfied with the easy of use of the application. Yeah, because we don't have to sign up, and etc. We just install and we can use, we can bring everywhere. We can in the restaurant use our mobile phone to check the restaurant. Okay, please next. Please next. Okay. This is the third step, the risk level of restaurant in Tanjung Pinang for COVID transmission. This is the result of in 2021 in our city in Tanjung Pinang, 29 restaurant were at risk because not implementing body temperature checks and seat spacing. I think just one restaurants yang tidak bersiku. But sorry, I can show you apa saja restorannya because it's not published. Okay, next. So our conclusion This the ROI application had a high level of satisfaction for its users, and then the results of measurements using the ROI application found that many restaurants in Tanjung Pinang were classified as at risk of transmitting COVID-19. It stuck in 2020 and 2021. Okay, for the last, this is our presentation. I said you because I said you that this is the past research, but the point I want to tell you are we must involve the civil or public persons for assessing and monitoring the sanitation of public of our public place with make a simple instrument for them, especially in my specification in a restaurant. Okay, the last statement. We hope there are second international conference from COA Poltekkes Kemenkes Tanjung Pinang, maybe in the next year. Okay, thank you. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. I give back the time to Mr. Moderator.
Well, Mrs. Wendy Angelina, according to me, this paper has an innovation or an invention, perhaps. But I was wondering, is this application used only in COVID-19 situation or regularly circumstances like nowadays? But you can ask the answer by the end of presentation. Thank you very much, Mistress Winnie Angelina. Now it's turn to Mistress Romalina, Master of Nursing, as a head of nursing department. Enjoy your time in the light.
Thank you, Mr.
Yes, Ras Komalina. There is a little trouble.
I'm here, Mr. Harpen.
Okay, loud and clear, Ms. Ras.
Yes, thank you for the opportunity, Mr. Harpen Sika Gunara. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Puji syukur kehadirat Allah Subhanahu wa taala atas limpahan rahmat-Nya, kita masih diberi kesehatan untuk hadir pada International Conference Center of Excellence ICCOE Health Polytechnic Ministry of Health Tanjung Pinang 2023 Public Health on Island. Salawat Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Allahumma shalli ala sayyidina Muhammad wa ala ali sayyidina Muhammad. The Honorable Director of Polytechnic Ministry of Health Tanjung Pinang, Speaker ICCOA Polytechnic Ministry of Health Tanjung Pinang, The Honorable Wakil Direktur 1, 2, dan 3, Kasubag Ada, Kasubag Adun Poltekkes Kemenkes Tanjung Pinang, Kepala SKI Poltekkes Kemenkes Tanjung Pinang, Kepala Pusat Mutu dan Pengembangan Pendidikan Poltekkes Kemenkes Tanjung Pinang, Kepala Pusat Penelitian dan Pengabdian kepada Masyarakat, Head of Midwifery Department, Polytechnic Ministry of Health Tanjung Pinang, Head of Environment Health Department, Polytechnic Ministry of Health Tanjung Pinang, All Lecturer, Polytechnic Ministry of Health Tanjung Pinang, All Student, Polytechnic Ministry of Health Tanjung Pinang, All Participant, Polytechnic Ministry of Health Tanjung Pinang. Ladies and gentlemen, good afternoon. Thank you for coming along here in this good afternoon. No, I would like to talk about my presentation. It's called Nursing Study Program in different topic with presenter previous presenter Ramadona and Mrs. Ramadona and Mrs. Weni Angelina. Without further ado, let's start. Nursing Study Program. Vision of Nursing Study Program. Reduce intermediate nursing graduates who are qualified, competitive, and have integrity who excel in emergency nursing in the island region at the national 2024 years. Mission of Nursing Study Program, implementing three pillars of higher education in the health sector development, develop quality and competitive knowledge, developing higher education government in the health sector that is credible, accountable, and transparent, developing three pillars of higher education in health with stakeholder. Sorry. Riset roadmap and pengabdian pada masyarakat nursing study program 2019 until 2023 years. General topic emergency nursing and subtitle topic medical nursing, surgical nursing, medical surgical nursing, and pediatric nursing, maternity nursing, family and gerontic nursing, psychiatric nursing, and community nursing. And publication article and last 3 years nursing study program Poltekkes Kemenkes Tanjung Pinang in journal, international journal, in national journal, in local journal. The example is JJSS, Jurnal Ilmiah Kesehatan, di Aloha, Heather, and Global Pharmacy Technology, and Proceeding International, with presenter and lecturer and student nursing study program use certificate of nursing lecture at SAR Kota Tanjung Pinang. Achievement award lecturer and staff in best oral presentation and achievement, national achievement, and local achievement. Intellectual property hak on community service atau publikasi pada masyarakat, and haki, hak kekayaan intelektual. In produce lecture, produce juice lapise, webilis, and other booklet perawatan luka, booklet panduan remaja dalam pertolongan pertama pada korban luka dan perdarahan, dan ada penanganan pertama serangan stroke, and other booklet hipoglikemia, dan other booklet. I'm praktik klinik mandiri. Tersertifikasi perawat luka. Especially especially. And product, lecture, and staff, modul-modul. Modul medical surgical nursing, modul pediatric nursing, modul maternity nursing, family and gerontic nursing, psychiatric nursing, and community nursing. In lesson study and lecture in simulasi in hyperbaric room and run exercise in the sea and swimming pool in polytechnic. Sarkota Tanjung Pinang. Foto-foto kegiatan dari Prodi D3 Keperawatan mahasiswa dan dosen Prodi D3 Keperawatan terkait dengan penunjang keperawatan gawat darurat. Achievement the student in achievement local, international, and national achievement. Sertifikat-sertifikat and for student nursing study program. A nursing competency competent test nurse student until 2018 years until 2023 years 100%. Graphic of registrant in nursing study program meningkat setiap tahunnya. Ini ke bagian dari Prodi D3 Keperawatan, staf dosen dan tenaga kependidikan Prodi D3 Keperawatan. Thank you for having me. Please ask me some question now and goodbye. Thank you, Mr. Harpensika Gunara. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi. In my opinion, these papers talk about nursing department achievements from the first to now. Anyway, all participants, it's time to make a question, comments, initiations, and things like that to our honorable speakers. Is there anyone? Who is going to be the first? All of you can ask to one of speakers, perhaps Mistress Rahmadona, as a head of midwifery departments, or Mistress Wenny Angelina, as a head of sanitation department, or Mistress Romalina, as a head of nursing department. We have an hour to go. Students, take your time.
Okay, thank you, moderator. Okay, thank you, moderator. Test. Okay, thank you.
I would like to introduce myself. My name is Nurul Faiza. I'm from nursing class. I wanna asking to Mrs. Ramadona. My question is how to utilize the sampling model in curtain cases of childbirth, such as cesarean section, where the husband is not allowed to the accompany the delivery process. Is there any separate counseling?
Mrs. Carlton and Mr. Huston, we are collecting the questions first, or I can just answer to those questions directly. Hello, Mr. Huston.
Mrs. Ramadona, excuse us.
Yeah.
Can you hear the questions?
Yes, I hear the question, but am I allowed to directly answer the question, or we collected the question first?
It depends on all speakers. We can collect the question first. And then ask and answer the question, or all participants can give question one by one and strictly ask the question. It depends on all speakers.
Mr. Aspen, one two question for Mrs. Ramadona. Oh, Mr. Aspen.
Take your time, Mistress. Mr. Adil.
Alhamdulillah. Now it's Mrs. Adil Sarah. Okay, thank you, Mr. Okay, thank you. Mrs. Ramadona, your presentation very excellent, very good about childbirth. Its metode sumping. Sumping nyeru sundana datang. It is the good metode for the safety to salinan childbirth. The question for you, in background your research, it's your team, 90% childbirth is not good. How about now the your method that you do to the something method of shopping here. Thank you.
Okay, thank you for the question, Mr. Adil Chandra. Are we still collected another question, or we can proceed to the answer?
In my opinion, if we collect the question first, it is not effective. So the speakers can answer that question,
yes,
one by one according to that question, perhaps.
Okay.
Well then.
I try to answer the question from the first question from Nurul Faiza, yeah. Okay, Nurul asked about something. Mostly we applies on normal delivery because we can assist or we can encourage a husband to do step by step accompanying a child companion in childbirth, so that it can optimize the birth companion. Tapi tidak menutup kemungkinan bahwa modul sumping ini bisa dipakai di sebelum persalinan ya, dari kehamilan si perempuannya. Karena sebenarnya setiap perempuan melahirkan itu perlu pendamping, perlu seseorang yang bisa dipercayanya. Dan yang paling dipercayanya itu sebenarnya adalah suaminya. Kami belum dapatkan beberapa data, data ya, we collected on the study before, that 86% women wants the husband to be the companion in her delivery. In modul sumping, we inform about the delivery process, about the companionship in this in those delivery, and also about how to do a good companion in delivery process. Tahapannya itu adalah dia bisa mengerti dulu apa itu persalinan. Kemudian apa pendamping persalinan itu seperti apa. Kemudian juga bisa mengetahui nanti peran suami dalam pendampingan persalinan itu seperti apa. Kemudian langkah-langkah yang harus dilakukan dalam pendampingan persalinan itu seperti apa. Nah, ini bisa diterapkan baik sebelum si perempuan atau si ibunya itu melahirkan. Jadi dalam masa terutama ya, di trimester ketiga kehamilan sampai dengan kala satu persalinan itu bisa diterapkan. Jadi kalau walaupun dia itu sebenarnya nanti akan seksio sesaria, bisa saja dilaksanakan dulu selama dia itu belum masuk ke ruang seksio. Nah, mungkin nanti implikasinya kalau memang ini sangat diperlukan dan sangat memerlukan pendampingan, toh sekarang kan sudah diperbolehkan ya suami masuk ke dalam ruang operasi atau ruang SC. Nah, itu dengan apa hadir dan menemani di ruang SC saja sebenarnya sudah cukup banyak membantu dalam proses pendampingan persalinan. Di mana nanti si ibu yang melahirkan itu akan merasa cukup nyaman, cukup merasa ditemani, mengurangi rasa kecemasan, sehingga mengurangi rasa sakitnya. Nah, kebijakan rumah sakitlah nanti yang akan menentukan apakah membolehkan seorang suami atau tidak masuk ke dalam ruang operasi. Namun yang kami teliti di proses media sumping ini adalah untuk memberikan pengetahuan tentang bagaimana persalinan dan bagaimana cara melakukan pendampingan persalinan pada para suami. Begitu. Mungkin hopefully that will answer your question, Faisal dan Nur Faizah. Kami nantikan komen berikutnya. Bagaimana dengan Nur Faizah?
Okay, thank you Mrs. Ramaduna for your great answer.
Then we go to the next question from Mr. Adhokarta. Boleh ulang lagi Pak, apa tadi pertanyaan Pak? Kurang jelas tadi terdengarnya.
Mr. Adil, would you like to repeat that question? Excuse us.
Okay, thank you, Sarah. You are reset your team for methodism. This your background was 19% birth is not good. Now, and your methodism is not how not to birth in Tanjung Pinang with a method of shopping or no?
Oh, okay. Okay, mana jelas tadi? Kalau Indonesia boleh ya Pak Aten?
Oh, taruh lah, bahasa Minang saja jadilah.
Begini Pak, maksudnya yeah. Bukan 90% persalinannya itu jelek gitu enggak, yeah, tapi okay. 90% dari komplikasi persalinan yang terjadi yeah. Itu yeah. Terjadi di sekitar masa persalinan gitu. Jadi salah satu cara dari yang literatur kami baca, salah satu caranya itu adalah mengurangi kecemasan sebenarnya, karena kan kebutuhan ibu bersalin itu tidak hanya fisik saja, tapi juga emosional dan fisiologisnya juga sangat membutuhkan. Jadi salah satu caranya adalah dengan menghadirkan seorang pendamping persalinan. Memang untuk pendamping persalinan itu bisa siapa saja, tapi WHO merekomendasikan suami untuk mendampingi persalinan karena suamilah yang nanti akan terlibat dalam pengasuhan anak selanjutnya bersama seorang istri. Nah, kalaupun suami juga mendampingi persalinan, itu merupakan bentuk tanggung jawab dan memberikan kenyamanan yang lebih bagi ibu yang bersalin. Nah, setelah dari yang from previous studies, we collected data that mostly husband who present in the labor room, but memang hadir mendampingi, tapi secara fisik saja. Sampai ada beberapa suami yang kalau kita tanya sebenarnya dia tidak tahu harus bagaimana dalam persalinan itu. Ya cukup, yang penting adalah di sana menemani saja gitu. Nah, itu pun sebenarnya sudah cukup membantu kenyamanan ibu. Tapi alangkah baiknya kalau misalnya secara aktif suami bisa lebih berbuat sesuatu dalam pendampingan persalinan, tidak hanya sekedar hadir. Bahkan beberapa suami juga ada yang sampai saking shocknya dengan proses persalinan, akhirnya menyerah, meninggalkan ruang persalinan dan menyerahkan pendampingan kepada another family member of the family, such as the mother or mother-in-law or sister. Jadi keterlibatan suaminya jadi agak sedikit kurang. Nah, dengan kami membuat modul dalam berbagai bentuk versinya ini, kami berharap suami punya pengetahuan tentang apa yang harus dilakukan dan bagaimana melakukan pendampingan persalinan yang baik. Jadi dengan demikian nanti dia akan lebih mengembangkan sikap positif tentang pendampingan persalinan, bisa melakukan pendampingan persalinan dengan lebih baik dengan mengikuti langkah-langkah yang kami jelaskan di dalam modul itu. Begitu, Pak.
Oke, thank you for answer, Mrs. Ramadan.
Well, it looks like an interesting question and asking.
Saya juga baru tahu, Pak. Ternyata sumping itu bahasa Sunda artinya datang ya, Pak, ya?
Iya, wilujeng sumping na kasih kamari. Bahasa Minangnya kamari.
Padahal itu ini apa tuh, menamainya itu kemarin karena kita mau namain apa ini?
Ya, nggak apa-apa.
Produk
kalau
kita
satu,
ini gitu kan.
Kalau suatu produk
sumping
baru itu
nggak
apa-apa. Bagus.
Mikirnya ya, karena itu singkatan dari support suami pendamping. Karena intinya di sini kan support seorang suami terhadap istri yang melahirkan dan menjadi seorang pendamping persalinan. Dan terjadilah itu sumping. Ternyata itu korelasinya dengan bahasa Sunda, wilujeng sumping.
Tapi cocok ya, artinya menghimbau
cocok
suami
ya,
datang mendampingi.
Datang ya.
Ya,
alhamdulillah, begitu. Cocok dengan bahasa sebenarnya. Terima kasih Pak Hansen, Pak Adil.
Oke, siap. Saya kasih pantunan untuk Dona dulu ya, Mr. Arven ya.
Iya, as you wish, Mister.
Oke. Ke kota Sika menjalin persahabatan. Belah kue untuk kuda lumping. Jika ingin bersalin aman, ikutilah metode sumping.
Great, Mr. Adil, great. Now on, is there any participants? Also in virtual? Or in this room? Mistress Winnie Angelina? Do you still with us or leave this room? Well, there is another students.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam.
First, I want to introduce myself. My name is Beata Ariadana from nursing student. So I have a question for Mrs. Romalina. Indonesia nursing workforce plays an important role in Indonesia's health development. However, the Indonesian Ministry of Health recognized that there is a shortage in the number of jobs. The situation contrasts with the large-scale production of nurses that occurs in Indonesia every year at this time. So my question is, what programs can be offered by nursing education institutions to deal with this? Thank you so much.
Mrs. Romalina.
Hey, I'm here. It's Fahar Fensika Gunara.
I enjoy try to
Thank you. I try to question this Unem Alia. I want to try the answer question with a nursing study program is menawarkan bahwa kerja luar negeri itu salah satu peluang yang ingin ditawarkan. Dan saat ini kami program studi lagi merancang kelas persiapan kelas internasional. Nursing study program cita-cita menjadi kelas internasional. Dan penambahan program nurse untuk tahun 2024. Supaya perawat-perawat kita yang ada bisa kita kirim bukan hanya menjadi care worker, bisa menjadi tenaga profesional di rumah sakit. And di seluruh dunia, Arab Saudi, Belanda, bahkan Singapura yang wilayah lebih dekat dengan kita. Itu upaya yang akan kami upayakan di tahun-tahun berikutnya. Dan tahun ini kita sudah membuat program dengan dukungan Bapak Direktur dan Bapak Gubernur, kita sudah membuat atau mengusulkan program kelas persiapan kelas internet. Enough to answer the question. Thank you.
Well, it is a nice discussion. So, is there any participants who will give questions, comments? We have still 30 minutes to go. Lecturers, leaders,
okay, participant, we are open for discussion. Maybe ada lagi saran untuk perbaikan dan peningkatan dari produk penelitian kami, ya kan Pak Harpet?
Sure, of course. Suggestion, opinions. Perhaps organizers. Okay, students, take your time.
Okay, assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. I'm Guru Putri Aini. I'm nursing student. I'm from nursing student. I wanna asking to Mrs. Weni. The question is, ROA application is an application that contains an instrument for assessing the health protocol for adapting new habits in restaurant. If for now, where we all we are all no longer too worried about COVID-19. Is it still relevant to us to use? Thank you.
Well, is it enough for that question, students? Is it enough?
Mr. Arven? Biar adil gitu loh. Okay, thank you, Mr. Henki. I want to see Benny Angelina about your research. It's very good. Application two. Restaurant in pandemic COVID-19. My question, simply, this application make your team or this application era in application in technology? Thank you.
Well, Mr. Adil,
well, no.
Those questions belongs to Mistress Angelina, Wendy Angelina, Master of Science. Are you still here? Or anyone else can answer that question? Of course, from Sanitation Department. According to Mistress Wenny's papers, there is another researchers, perhaps she will answer that question. Excuse us. Wait a second, please, Mr. Adil.
Okay. Yeah, once again to a question for Nursing Department of Mrs. Romalina. Okay. Mrs. Romalina, I'm sorry, I want to question for you now. Okay.
Thank you, Adil.
Okay. Yeah. Okay. Your presentation about the profile nursing department, how to opportunity and treatment the nursing department, however to make successful in island relevant or national international. Now you our question for nursing department, how opportunity and treatment in nursing program to make in our study in global to successful in Indonesia. Okay, thank you. I'm sorry, bahasa Inggris.
Thank you, Pak Adir. Success of to course, Indonesia yeah. Ya, Pak?
Yes.
Yeah. Success to Indonesia memang izin jawab dengan bahasa Indonesia aja ya, Pak. Saat ini perawat memang sudah penuh ya Pak katanya. Jadi itu yang menjadi tantangan kami. Saat ini kita lagi berhubung dengan PTKL, F2 PTKL juga jadi salah satu hambatan. Simlem Kerma juga menjadi hambatan kita. Upaya yang kami lakukan untuk ini kami itu tadi salah satunya lagi membuat program rintisan kelas internasional atau kelas persiapan kelas internasional dan menjalin kerjasama dengan stakeholder baik di seluruh Indonesia terutama Provinsi Kepulauan Riau itu mungkin yang harus dijalankan dari kami. Dan di tahun ke depan, salah satunya tadi nurse program NAS itu harus kita wujudkan, dan ini kita dapat sinyal dari kementerian tahun 2024 kita akan buka program NAS, dan SDM yang saat ini menjadi hambatan kemarin sudah kita sampaikan ke Dirjen Nakes. Mudah-mudahan ada solusi mendatangkan lecturnya dari Poltekkes lain, dan berharap SDM yang lagi tubel bisa kembali untuk mendukung program ini. Salah satunya Pak Adil ya, kembali di Prodi.
Insya
Berharap
Allah,
kita
mohon
lebih
doa.
baik. Itu yang kita upayakan, dan mungkin melalui PJ kemahasiswaan kita akan sering melaksanakan webinar atau kuliah-kuliah pakar ke depannya nanti di tahun 2024 barangkali Pak Adil. Kalau tahun 2023 kita sudah padat sekali dengan kegiatan-kegiatan yang harus dicapai baik rektorat maupun program studi. Mungkin itu saja yang dapat saya sampaikan Pak Adil. Thank you for question for
Okay,
me.
thank you.
Yeah.
This is Romalina. You are good answer to my question. Pak topik dari kuliah dari kopiah Ibu menyemasa ikan pisang batu. Wabillahi topik dia. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Pak Adil, terima kasih Pak Arpen.
Thank you.
Well, it is a fascinating discussion between speakers and participants. Now, is there any questions from other participants? Any comments, arguments, opinions, things like that? Lecturers. Perhaps leaders from all departments. Organizers.
Harapan there are my question for sanitation department. This for Mrs. Wendy Angelina.
Well, Mr. Adil,
okay.
It looks like Mistress Wendy Angelina has been left.
Okay, okay. Please, Mrs. Wendy Angelina, for me to wish WA again.
As you wish, Mr.
Yeah, thank you, Mr.
Perhaps in another event.
Okay.
Another question before we end this presentation from all heads of department and Health Polytechnic of Tanjung Pinang. Nah. Itu. Udah. Katanya Pak ini sampai. Iya. By the way, there is one participant will ask wait a second.
I'm sorry, Mr. Moderator.
Take your time.
Okay. Mr. Moderator, I'm sorry because I have other meetings in Aula. So I don't hear about the question.
Of course, sure. You have another particular event.
I beg your pardon, please. You diulangi questionnya, Pak.
Okay, will you
Sorry.
Excuse us? Mr. Adil, will you excuse us? Would you like to?
Wait a moment, Mr. Henke. I want to. Efficiency is not efficient, not takes a certificate.
Okay, sorry, Mr. Adil.
Okay, thank you.
Sorry, Pak.
Yeah, Mrs. Benny Angelia, nursing department. Your presentation very presentation very good about your team research and application.
Thank you.
For restaurant in
Tanjung Pinang.
Tanjung Pinang pandemic COVID-19. Simply the question for your team. This application makes your team or this application there are in application in technology. Thank you.
Okay. Okay. I can directly answer. Thank you, Mr. Adil, for the yes. question. The observation sheets and the questionnaire there it is we made them but the application we helped by IT developer Mr. Adil. Yeah, there were IT developer that helped us to make the application.
This is the IT developer, yeah.
Yes, okay. IT developer in Tanjung Pinang.
What's the application?
What I beg your pardon?
Yeah. What do what now the application to restaurant?
The application is still developed by us, Mr. Adil. So we not yet publish this application to the restaurant.
Yeah.
So still in my team and after 2 years. Not yet published, Mr. Adil. Thank
okay,
you.
Thank you, Mrs. Wendy Angelita. Thank you. Share my question. Back to Mr. Henke, please.
Okay.
Yeah,
thank
you.
This nice.
Waalaikumsalam. Thank you, Mr. Adil.
Nice discussion. Perhaps there is another question from students, Mistress Van Angelina, would you like?
Yes. Okay. Please, Mr.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi
wabarakatuh. I'm Huru Putri Aini. I'm from nursing student. My question is ROA application is an application that contains an instrument for assessing the health protocol for adapting new habits in restaurant. If for now, where we are all no longer too worried about COVID-19, is it still relevant to use? Thank you, Ms.
Okay, thank you, Miss
Nurul.
Oh, Miss Nurul, thank you for your question. I want to I try to answer. Okay, this application we made for COVID-19 to assess about habits visitors in a restaurant when pandemic COVID-19, but our team want to develop this application. So this application not just to COVID-19, but to other disease, especially disease that caused by virus and microbiology or bacteria like that. For the future, we can use this application to, or we can insight, we will insight instrument of hygiene and sanitation about restaurant in this application. This is our Russian, maybe. Like that, Ms. Nurul. Thank you.
Okay, thank you, Ms. Sweeney, for the answer.
Interesting. Mr. Sweeney?
Yes, Mr. Moderator, Mr. Harvensika.
Would you like to stay for a few minutes? Perhaps there is another questions from another participants.
Okay,
close this session.
Okay.
Perhaps 5 minutes to go.
Okay, Mr. Harvensika. Please, yes.
Lecturers from Sanitation Department.
Okay, yes, please.
Would you like to students from sanitation departments, a few minutes to go.
Probably this enough for the question, Mr. Hansen. One more to the local question. Okay, ending up this session.
As you wish. Students? Will you go on, lecturers? Yeah. Well, as a ending of this presentation from all heads of departments in Health Polytechnic of Tanjung Pinang, we would like to conclude some opinions to nursing departments. Hopefully, in the future, nursing department will get greater. And for midwifery department, with their sumping, give society something usefulness. And for sanitation department, that application will be meaningful to society to identify foods and beverages. Well, we proudly deliver to honorable speakers certificates. Ms. Rosh Ramadona.
Thank you very much, Mr. Hayuki.
Master of Midwifery. Then, Ms. Rosh. Wait a second, please. Ms. Reswina Angelina, Master of Science.
Thank you very much.
And the last speaker is Ms. Res. Ms. Ras Romalina, Master of Science.
Thank you, Mr. Alvensika, and all participants.
Well, before we close this session, we would like to thankful for all participants, lecturers, leaders, and others, and see you and other events. Bye.
For documentation, Mr. Arfan, to picture together. So.
It is nicely.
Yes. Foto basamo.
Adil, itu penting tuh Pak Adil.
Ya. Kalau jadi mahasiswa tuh bukti absen kuliah itu.
Karena lewati daring ya, Pak.
Yeah. Thank you, Mr. Rafa.
You're welcome, Mr.
Nah, ini menambah, bro.
Who is gonna take a picture, please?
Yes.
Who is gonna be? That, Mr. Mistress. It is done, Mr. and Mistress, all participants.
Yes.
Perhaps once again, twice, thirds, three times.
One. Three. Okay, welcome. Bye-bye, Mr. Hafen. Bye-bye.
Okay.
All the speaker,
thank
bye
you,
bye.
All of committee of POA.
Thank you, success for
sorry, wait a minute.
And success for all of you.
Sorry, wait a minute for all the participants. We have some announcement for you all. Thank you for all the participants who have attended this conference from the beginning to the end of the session. We still have one more session tomorrow. It is parallel session and awarded for all the attendees. I hope all participants can join this activity again tomorrow at 8 a.m. with the same Zoom link. See you tomorrow. Good afternoon.
Thank you, Miss
Tina.
Christina.
Thank you,
Miss
Tina. Successful for Poltech.
Miss Tina, Miss Tina. See you tomorrow morning.
Thank you, Bu Romlin.
Thank you.
Thank
success.
You, Ibu semua.
Thank you. Success, Mrs. Darwitri.
Sukses.
Wilujeng Sumping. Mrs. Dona.
Wilujeng Sumping, Pak.
Nah. Oke, okay, sukses untuk kita semua. Waalaikumsalam, izin lah. Jadi anak lah.
Waalaikumsalam.